My job is to give it extra push with new resources, clear direction, strong support. In simple terms, my job is to accelerate digital media transformation in our newsrooms.
Earlier this year, former Cabinet Minister Khaw Boon Wan agreed to become chairman of SPH Media Trust. This is a CLG that will be set up to take over the media operations of Singapore Press Holdings. Over breakfast at White Rose Cafe in York Hotel, Mr. Khaw says he has been reading and consulting widely to prepare for the role. The CLG will do its utmost to carry out the mission of providing quality journalism for Singaporeans, he says. His top priority? To accelerate the digital transformation of the newsrooms so that they deliver a richer experience to its readers. So Mr. Khaw, it's been a few months since it was announced you are going to chair the CLG, and how has it been for you?
I've been busy because like all new assignments, you know, and I spend considerable time doing the serious research. It means reading, it means talking to people, hearing their views, getting feedback from both outside SPH as well as within SPH. One is, I think, I find the feedback useful. Secondly is, I want them to also get closer contact with me, to know me as a person, because we are in it together. Our job is to make sure the newsroom can continue to produce quality journalism so that they can better able to explain things as they happen, both within Singapore as well as outside Singapore, especially in our region. So how do you get good contents, timely, relevant, seamlessly to the audience, and in a very user-friendly manner? You need a first-class tech department too, and the two must work closely together. Then I think if we can combine creative talent with technology skills, then I think we can produce value for our listeners, for our audience, you know, and for our readers. So clearly, digital media transformation is a necessary part of the way going forward. Fortunately, it's not new to SPH. You all have been pivoting in that direction. My job is to give it extra push with new resources, clear direction, strong support, so that we can push on ahead in a much more decisive way.
What are the key changes that we'll be seeing in the coming months?
For the English newsrooms, for this year, I think we will push on with three initiatives. First, the largest newsroom, which is Straits Times. Years of cost cut have weakened the newsroom. We will strengthen it, both in terms of numbers, more headcounts, as well as quality, which is skill sets, especially digital media skill sets. Because of cost cutting and shareholders' bottom line pressure, we have to recognize that our wage skills are no longer competitive. We have started reviewing the wage skills, and not just in the newsroom, but also in technology as well as other critical departments, in order to be able to attract talent. We must, as soon as possible, move into a fully multimedia operation in all platforms where all the audience are, and round the clock. For the Business Time newsroom, that is a much smaller newsroom, and therefore can be much more agile. We are using the BT newsroom to experiment. All our newsrooms today, understandably, are all print-oriented. The whole processes in the newsroom, including your software, we will have to pivot the processes to be more digital-driven. BT, being a smaller newsroom, I'm challenging them to spearhead these efforts. And I think the lessons learned from the BT transformation will be extremely useful when we are ready next year to tackle the larger newsroom like Straits Times. The third English newsroom is, of course, the new paper. And that has a completely different history and in a way, a different clientele, you know. We have discussed and we have decided that let the new paper pivot to be fully digital as soon as possible. In other words, we cease the print production, reform the newsroom, enhance their online presence so that they can serve their readers, their audience, much better round the clock.
Have you set any targets for the newsrooms?
Different publishers set different targets in order to motivate their staff, not just media organizations. In the case of digital media, I think all publishers have come to the conclusion that the way going forward is to sign on as many digital subscribers as possible. For the simple reason, the cost of a first-class newsroom is fairly fixed. There's a minimum size to be able to have a strong team of talent to produce that quality of contents. And that cost is a sunk cost, whether you produce 100,000 subscribers or 1 million subscribers. And therefore, the more subscribers you get, your unit cost comes down. And that is the reason why publishers all push for growth, and we must do the same thing. So whatever subscription numbers today, work on doubling it. How long, I do not know. And in fact, don't stop there. When you achieve a target, double it again.
You've been known as Mr. Fix-It all through your career. How does this assignment compare with the others?
I'm thankful that people think positively about what I've done, you know, but I just did my best. You know. But that label bothers me because past success or achievement never guarantee the future. You know. Every assignment is different. And if you allow complacency or overconfidence to seep in, you will almost certainly fail. So my job, as I said, is to help SPH Media colleagues focus on the mission, produce good quality contents, work closely with technology so that we can bring the contents seamlessly to our audience. And I think importantly is be humble. We have lost a few years. The competition has moved on during those few years. We have a gap to close. Focus on the gap. But remember, the digital transformation and the digital disruption continues because the technology continues to change. Regardless of the changes that will surely come along, we'll be much more positioned.
Thanks very much for having breakfast.
Thank you.